everyone. My name is Brian Lai, and welcome to the first video of Ask Stipple Software Engineering. This video will cover basic setup for your robot. First, let's talk about the RoboReel. So the RoboReel is a robot controller that includes ports, sensors, and other important things for your robot. You deploy code to the RoboReel from Eclipse, which we'll talk about later, since it holds the code for the bot. Without it, you can't operate a robot. Make sure that all the wires are properly connected. Documentation on these things can be found in the description below. Next, plug in the printer cable to the specified port on the RoboReel and USB into your computer. And now you have a functioning RoboReel.
So you might be wondering, how do I actually operate a robot? Well, as you can see here, teams use FRC driver station. There are three important requirements that are needed: robot controllers, communications, and code deployed onto the RoboReel. You should download the FRC 2018 update suite, which provides the folder you need for WPILib robot Java development. For coding, we use Eclipse. The download links are located in the description below. Once you download Eclipse and the update suite, open up Eclipse and go towards the upper left corner of the screen. Next, go to File, then New, and then go to Other. To do this, you can also press Ctrl+N. Once you reach the New Select a Wizard screen, find the WPILib Robot Java Development folder. Click on the left drop-down menu and select on Robot Java Project. Click Next and create a project name for the robot. As for the project type, our team uses Iterative Robot. Finally, click on Finish. Congratulations, you have successfully created a FRC robot project. To deploy this onto the RoboReel, right-click on the FRC robot project in the Package Explorer and go to Run As and click WPILib Java Deploy. There will be messages when building the code, and if successful, it should give you a message saying build successful. After you deploy the code and have successfully connected with the robot, you will see that the indicators are green. Just enable or disable to operate your robot.
Thanks for watching the video. Make sure you tune in next time for the next episode of Ask Stipple Software Engineering.